A business group is pushing for better women representation in the Philippine labor force to boost the economy. Lady Vicencio on the line with that story. Lady, over to you.
Yes, Stanley, women should be given equal opportunities in the labor force for economic growth, according to the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry. PCCI President Engineer Yunina Mangyo believes more women representation is needed in businesses and in workplaces where gender discrimination should have no place. Colombian Ambassador to the Philippines Marcela Ordonez also rallied to break cultural barriers that suggest women should be the ones taking care of the family instead of sharing the responsibility with men. For the Employers Confederation of the Philippines, gender discrimination on wages does not exist anymore. But ECO President Sergio Ortiz Luis Jr. admitted some employers are still inclined to hire male workers to avoid costs on benefits for women. However, he added that some industries prefer women employees due to their nature of having good dexterity and patience with doing long hours of work while sitting down. These sectors include manufacturing, electronics, and business process outsourcing, or BPOs. Today, PCCI launched its Karunungan Pangkabuhayang Pangkababaihan in Bagong Silang, Caloocan City, a livelihood and education project wherein about 100 women are targeted to be reintegrated or introduced to the workforce. Livelihood kits were given along with trainings for manicure, pedicure, and hair cutting. PCCI said it is looking to work with more local government units for the project to empower women to find their place in the workplace to give them an equal chance for self-development. The project also aims to help women be financially independent and to be able to help provide for their families. Stanley?
All right. Thank you so much for that update, Lady Vicencio. Philippine Senator Risa Hontiveros calls on the Energy Department to deliver lasting solutions to the country's woes. Her call after electricity demand surged across the country amid extreme heat, forcing the power grid operator to issue red and yellow alerts. Hontiveros demanded an explanation as consumers continue to endure rotational brownouts and higher power bills. He also urged the DOE to refrain from continuously shifting the burden of reducing power demand onto the public's shoulders, when the government should be working on providing enough supply. Now, the Luzon power grid is currently under yellow alert status until 10 in the evening, with 18 power plants on forced outage. As demand remains high, power provider Meralco and the Energy Department are urging more companies to join the government's interruptible load program. This to help ensure power supply sufficiency throughout the dry season. The program is a voluntary program which calls on big power consumers to temporarily deload from the grid and use their own generating units or reduce their operations when there's not enough power supply. Filipinos warned of a new phishing scam supposedly from telco giant Globe. The Philippine Cybercrime Office said Tuesday a particular online domain targets users via text messages. The scheme allegedly asks users for their personal and bank details to redeem rewards points from Globe. The agency says it has recommended the blocking of the website to avoid victimizing users. It also reiterated its call on the public not to click links from unofficial sources of the web. President Marcos's working relationship with Vice President Sara Duterte not affected by the recent statements made by First Lady Lisa Araneta Marcos. Marcos adds he sees no need to replace Duterte as education chief. The chief executive statement comes after the First Lady admitted she's not in speaking terms with the Vice President because of the drug addict joke of former President Rodrigo Duterte aimed at President Marcos.
I have a wife na very protective sa akin na kahit na may nakita ang hindi magandang sinabi tungkol sa akin, yan, talagang she gets very upset. I guess we cannot blame her. It will not affect our working relationship with the Vice President, Secretary of Education. She understands, as I said, as our wife herself, she understands the sentiments of the First Lady. And our conversation will be precisely that. I am sure you understand how she feels.
The president made a comment on the sidelines of his visit to San Jose Occidental Mindoro this morning, where he inspected the damage caused by the El Nino weather phenomenon to farmlands. He also led the distribution of government aid to the affected families.